Hello, we are Vasile and Pavel, and today we will start to work on this highly requested project, the Dust Angel Mask. Because this is a pretty hard project, I feel like some explanation have to be made from the start. So I want to present what molds you will need and what tools. For the ear, there are two molds. Firstly, is this mold for the exterior part. And this mold for the inside part. As you can see, there is a line that will help you cut the hole for the brass mesh. On the other mold, you will have the signs for the holes to attach the ear to the mask. For the eye part, there are also two molds. One of them is optional, but if you want to have this inside, you need two of them, pretty much. There is the mold for the exterior part, as I showed in the Google's video. We'll obtain something like this, which is basically this part. And there's a similar mold for the inside lining, which will help you sandwich the lenses between. Something like this. So you will have the lens between those layers. The helmet part is pretty straightforward. There's just cutting, finishing the edges and stitching. You will also need these snap-on rivets, eyelets for laces, I don't know their name, 20mm buckle, two of them, a lace, and pretty much this is it for the helm. Again, the respirator is pretty easy to make. But there are some brass parts, so we will have a link in the description on where to buy those. You need this part, and you also need those three, which come together as a canister. But again, we made a video about a respirator, and it's similar to that one. And in that video you can find how I prepare the brass parts, how I age them, and everything that is needed to know. You also need this kind of screws or something similar to attach the brass part to the leather. As you notice, for this mask you need several types of accessories, and you cannot find them in one place. In the video description you will find links for it, but I will sell the hardware kit as well. And I want to make a small presentation of what things you will need for this. Okay, this is the kit. And I will make a fast presentation of what it will contain. You have the thermoformable material for the ears, which goes on this part, but everything is shown in the video. We have the lenses. The eyelets for the respirator mask. Those three. The lace hooks. The lace hooks here. With the rivets that come with it. The snap fasteners, enough of them. The thread with the knot for this rivet on the goggles, for this snap fastener, which is made from two symmetrical parts. The brass mesh for the ear. The two buckles here. The parts for the canisters. Some metal wool. The brass dome nuts with the screws that attach this part here. And pretty much this is it. This is everything you need. Like the special things. Of course you will need to have edge paint and the normal leather tools as well.
We will start by making the ears. We will have to mold them, so I'll have to cut them. I'll use this to cut the leather. I make this part. Choose a good part of the leather. If it is rigid, it is better. After cutting those parts, I will soak them in hot water. Here is the water. We will leave them here 5-10 minutes. And then we will mold them. Now the leather is soaked. So I'll place it here and I'll mold it. First I'll use this. I used two plastic plates because I don't want to break the molds. This plastic is strong enough. And then I'll use this chip. This will have to dry at least 20 hours. It will be ready tomorrow, but we have ones already prepared. It will look like this. This is like a hedgehog made from clamps. This is the mold for the second part of the ear. We place it here and we will repeat the process as for the previous one. Thank you. we will obtain this. For the eye, we will use the pattern to cut roughly the part. This is the part, and as you already know, soak it in water, in hot water.
Molding the eye part, it's a little tricky, so beside the mold, you also need some kind of foam or a neoprene sheet or whatever, something like this. It's like the yoga mat. As you see, because we are asking a lot from the leather, it will start to wrinkle, so we will use those to counteract this effect. A clicker press will make this task way easier. This won't be the final step. We will also have to remove the neoprene and mold it again after we almost get it in shape.
That will happen in an hour.
After leaving it for like an hour or so with the neoprene, we need to remove it and press the leather between the molds without anything else. For now, the shape is not defined as it should be. It's kind of round. And now, when we will press those together, we should end up with the finished part after it will be dried. And we will leave it like this for 24 hours.
Now we will cut the leather parts. I will line it on this thin vegetable tanned leather. I think it's goat, but it can be thin cow. Brush, uniform layer of adhesive. So I will join the parts. I take care to respect that sign. And I will press it. Please. I use a silicone sheet. And so on. I made the signs. Now I'll cut the parts. Like this. We have to make the edges. I can make almost perfect edges with Uniter's edge dies. First I use this. This is a filler. It is written here. We will sand the edges and then we will use some edge dye. After making the edges, it was a lot of work on those edges, I will make the holes. So here they are. I'll use a compass to mark the distance. Don't push it too hard. It helps a lot. Here now, because it's a bigger distance and those holes have another rule. I will stitch the parts.
Like always, we will improvise a pony stitch.
With
steel and magnet.
Yeah. I'm doubling the last two stitches. After leaving the one day this leather in the mold, I removed it and it was still kind of wet. So to finish drying it, I used those clips to hold it on the mold. So it didn't lose any shape, it's still exactly the shape that we need. The next step, which is not mandatory, but if you want this to keep the shape after punching this big hole, like on this one, you need to line it. So there's a leather stiffener, which is also
from industry,
thermoformable. So we will need a mold. The material, I will leave a link in the description for it. We need a heat gun, preferably, and some leather glue and something to spread it with. So let's start. Spread it really good because this glue needs to hold. We will cut a circle a little bigger than this one. It doesn't have to be perfect. This face, it will become gluey after we will heat it. So, you put it like here. We need to have this nearby. And also a quick woodworking clamp. Do not blow the heat directly on the mold. I think we are almost there. And clasp it. And in a minute or so, this will remain like this forever. This material is used in shoe industry and it's used to keep the front of the shoe in place and not losing the shape. I think this is enough. So. And this is what we got. So it's still kind of hot. In a few minutes, maybe, or seconds. I will make you a demonstration on why this material is really, really good. And you can put it like this. And you can put those also. Like this. Like this. So, just to have an idea. We will trim the excess. And because this looks pretty bad, even for an inside, it's plasticky, we need to use some leather to hide it. So I have the same leather that I'm using to line on the eyes and the other parts that need lining, like the inside of the helm. It's the same leather. But you can use whatever, you can use something dark or black or whatever. So you don't need the perfect leather, just a soft and kind of thin one. You place this back in the mold, you apply the glue. I'm using a bit more glue than usual, and I'm not waiting till it's completely dry, because the leather needs to kind of slide into place. You will see in a second why. So you just place it over this one, and because the glue is not that dry, you can kind of forcing it like this. And now you just use the mold. Use the fingers a bit, compensate for those parts. And because you want the adherence perfect, we will clamp it and leave it like this for like half an hour or 1 hour or whatever. So for now we have those two, and we will move to the other ones, to those. We will need to punch this hole in which we will put a mesh. I'm using a model ship mesh, like this. This mesh also has a small mold, so you obtain a round shape of it. So let's start. The mold will leave a mark to have you center the punch. You place it on top. End of attachment, and we will use a hammer. And we have this hole. This will need to be also finished with edge paint, at least a little. Until this will dry, we can work on the mesh. I am using a normal scissor to cut. I need a square of this. Remove this margin stuff. And after that, you place it like this in the mold. Put the mold on top. And just heat it like this. And you obtain this. As you see, it's a dome. For this step, we need those two, the mesh, and the part that will bring it together like this. We will need to bend those edges a little. And this will get here with glue, and we will obtain this. Now let's begin. We have and we need to wait a little until the glue is kind of dry. This can depend on the kind of glue you are using. This is a polychloroprenic glue, and basically you just wait until it loses the shine, like on those parts. I think they're kind of dry enough. So this is pretty easy. You just place it here in the middle. Like this. And also use the mold. And we will need to place this again in the middle. And after this, you come with the mold. To press it, you can hammer it a little with a rubber one. Can put it in a clicker press or just press it with your fingers, whatever.
I have to center the hole to make the hole with this big punch. So I will use it like this, and I'm not sure that I see perfect what is the center, where is the center. So first of all, I'll make from cardboard a piece like this. I will use it to find the center. I think it's here. I make signs with this marker pen. Now I have the signs. And the sign will help me to make this hole correct.
In the center.
Of course, now I'll have to make the edges. To make a perfect cut here, I will make a device to make the signs. I'll use this edger. If the edger is sharp, it will be easy to use it. This edge is an important one. It will give the look of the ear. This is what you will see first.
So I'll use it. I first use a primer. It is Uniter's edge dye. Always use their primer if you choose this combo. This is an improvised tool. It is a circle of plastic with a hole in the middle. The diameter is around 1 centimeter. And if you press it like this, it will make signs. Sorry, I have to keep it like this if I want to make the signs. But you see what? It goes like this.
This will give you a guiding line for the cut, so you won't mess up.
This blade is good enough to cut 8 millimeters leather. Oh! Like this. I will also make the edges with the edger. I will also use a primer. I will also use edge dye. Everywhere we have an edge, we burnish it or we use edge dye there. I'll have to glue it here. So I'll make signs. I'll scratch for better adherence of the adhesive. I can do it as I want. Take care not to cut yourself. I prefer to make this movement. This means I won't touch this part. Go too deep here because I don't want to see the adhesive inside. Outside we can do whatever we want because we will cut that part. And now I'll place this here. Careful, careful. It is centered. I usually press this with a bone. And I'll make the cut on this edge. I use the elasticity of the blade. And I always use a very, very sharp blade. I cut it good enough, so I don't need to use an abrasive, a sandpaper. I used Uniter's primer. I let it dry. Now I sand it. 800 grit, and let's see what happens after that. We have those ears and we have to make holes in them because we want to stitch them here where we already have the holes. The mold has signs on it, so we already have the signs for making the holes. This makes our life easier. I will use a long nose round punch. This active part is very long, so I can make the hole through this almost 1 centimeter of leather. Proceed. The round punch perpendicularly. I will use a magnet and a piece of steel to keep everything in place. And I will stitch.
The helmet is almost ready. We will have to put some pieces here. A lace to keep them together. Some holes for the goggles and some holes for the respirator.
We will make the respirator part of this mask. So we first want to put the eyelets and to attach this brass part. There is a video in which we make a respirator mask, and you can find everything about making the brass parts, this one and this one. How are the plumbing supplies named, and everything you need to know, it will be there. First we will burnish this leather. We have some IKEA candles, some, I don't know how it's named.
Felt.
Some felt. And we just put some wax. And with the felt, we will put the eyelets now on those holes. And we will do the same for the other part. Now we will stitch those circles on both parts. Now we will attach those brass parts to the respirator leather. What I like to do is to keep the same orientation. As you see, this is not a pentagon, a hexagon. And as you see, this line is toward the eyelet. So those holes aren't made from the pattern, because when you will work the brass, you won't be able to put the holes exactly the same. So this is the safest way. We mark the holes. I will try to keep the part like this, not spin it around. Chocan. We will do them one by one, so we won't end up with mistakes. We take the screw. One more. this super glue wasn't friendly. You need just a little bit. Also for those cups, I will also leave a link in the description. I buy them locally from Hornbach, for who is from Europe. Okay. First one. It's done. And we have to repeat it 6 times. As you can see, we have the brass parts attached with the screws. And now we have to make this stitching and this one in the order I said. So we will start with the upper part. We take like 6 times the length of the stitching. We try to have the same length of thread on each side. And we also try to keep those two parallel, so they won't overlap and create a kind of X. We're doing the other part of the respirator. It's the same stitching, so we don't want to bore you too much with it. Now that we have the rib stitchings done, we have to make this one. This is what you should end up with, the part for the canisters. Așa.
Now we will make the holes for the eyes. We have to center them. I will make the hole with this round punch, and I have a piece of cardboard with the same diameter. So I came here and I'll center this. Because I don't want to cut directly to the mold. This is a 100% molded
In fill.
I put a lot of cardboard here. I'll place the eye here. And I have this round punch. Time. Now it is okay. I protected the mold and I have the hole. It will be a lot of work to make it perfect, but we will succeed. We also have to cut it. I'll have to make a hole in this lining too. But because this is soft, I can make the signs here and I'll make the hole in an easy way. You see, I have the signs. I place this round punch here. I have to see. I place this plastic here too, again. And this one, I hit it only once. Here it is. I have to reduce this big eye at these dimensions. This is a finished one. And to make signs, I use an improvised tool. This is a little circle with a hole in the middle. I place the picks,
the pen
in this hole, and now I have equal distance. See how it is, how easy I can use it. I have to be careful here. And now I have a clear line to cut on it. And I'll cut. And I start to cut. I use this tall place. It is not an easy cut. Doesn't matter that I cut a lot. This is hard every time. And that's all.
Same for the other eye.
The next eye, I'll cut it identically. They are symmetric. While the edge die is drying, we will make the holes and place these pieces for the lace. So, 3 millimeters round punch, holes, I have to make the edges because I want them to look good. I use a brush. I'll do it like this. This is the second layer of edge dye. I use uniters. Edge dye, sandpaper, edge dye, sandpaper. I will make holes on this piece. I will sand this with 20 grit sandpaper because I want it to be thin. We have to insert the lens into this, and we have to glue them on this part. So we have to sand this part and to protect the center of the lens like this. So I'll put a thin layer of glue on a piece of leather, the thinnest I can. I will let it dry for a few seconds, long enough to cover my jar, and I place it here, and I don't need a good bondage because I will remove this piece of leather with glue on it. I use it only because I want to sand this part and not to scratch the center of the lens. It will stay here very easy, like this. So let's sand it.
We will sand the edges because you want the glue to hold, and this being a mirror is pretty shiny, so this is the only way. You can also scratch with a blade, but if you have a Dremel, as you can see, this middle protection also helps you sand.
It's defective.
And for the other side as well. This will get glue from to part, so and same for the other lens. Okay, we have the edges sandpapered, and we will apply the glue now. Again, those protections will help you very much because you can just go like this and you don't care. And now the inside of the eyes. I always mess up and some of the glue ends up on the edge, but I can clean it fast in a minute or so. This is the messy part of this project, the goggle part. We just want to clean the extra glue. I'm just using a finger and a crepe rubber. It is hard to clean afterwards. It's pretty much, this one is good. You take the lens, you put it in, and again this small circle will help you. I don't wait till the glue is dried all the way, because you need to be able to move this a little bit. And for a proper pressing, you put it in, you get the mold, and you press it, but you don't want to use a press, because you probably will break the lens. But a little bit. And we have an eye. We will do the same for the other one.
We have the holes here, and we will place these eyes on their places, and we will make the holes through this part. So we will need to glue it, like everything else. I glue a lot.
You cannot skip using glue for this project.
Yes. Glue makes things sure. You can be sure that it will stay where you put it. And I made these holes because it's easier to continue them than to make entire new holes through the two layers of leather.
We basically tried every method, and
this is the method.
This is the conclusion.
This is the proper method for this.
Yeah.
I prefer to glue and to make holes between six layers of leather, but not in this case. In this case, I have to make the holes, then to continue them. I'll make one eye, because one is enough. Because I will stitch. I don't need a very strong bondage. It have to stay in place only until I stitch it.
You also want to keep the same orientation for the eye. Show the back part.
It's symmetrical, you see. It's the eye on the proper axis. And I will use the corner of this volume to finish the holes. I use the smallest hammer I have. And I'll make holes in this direction.
At an angle.
At an angle, because I need to be sure to make the hole where is needed.
On that part, you won't have issues, but toward the nose, it will be... It's a little harder, but just...
You have to be very, very careful on this part. These googles are hard to make. It's harder even for us. And it is not the first pair I make. I think it's the 10th or even more. You always look at the reverse part to be sure that you make the holes where you need to make them.
You okay?
Small mistakes are acceptable, but not big mistakes. After making these holes, stitching is easy. I make little holes. You see, they are where I need them. I use this corner because I can't place it on a plain surface. When we made the technology for these googles, we had to improvise a lot, and we made all these improvisations into a pattern. All the holes are done. We used a Dremel to sand this to make it at the level of this part. Everything is aligned, and now I will stitch it. We have to glue the first part of the lining. It should get inside like this. We can cut the excess leather after as well. So I have some glue here. It's a bit more diluted. And we need to move fast. We will make one eye at a time because we don't want the glue to dry. We want to be able to push this part. We don't want a perfect adherence from the start. So
the perfect adherence will occur after a time when the glue will dry.
I'm just putting glue. I'm putting enough. I'm not. It doesn't matter if it's a bit messy. Everything will be covered.
Like here.
Okay. As you see. And now this part.
Just be sure you used enough glue.
And now we will just slide them in place. We also made a video for some goggles, and there are some other angles in which you can see this operation. You just press it with the fingers.
Use your best finger.
You can use I don't know, a wood like this for edges. You want to remove all the air.
And for now you just leave it like this for at least until you finish the eye. The glue is dried and we can do the final gluing around those parts. We will also want to remove most of the leather, so when we are putting the final part of the lining like this, we won't have any excess which will heighten, so we have a smooth transition. This is what we're looking for. So for now we will just glue those. We will also use the Dremel after to smoothen a little more the transition.
To smooth.
We also want to remove this kind of stuff. And we can use a skiver for this. You just don't want to cut the thread, but you see, just remove those parts. There's a little more here. We should end up with something like this. As you see, it's pretty messy. It has some height. And we will go with this either to a... The best thing, I think, it's a Dremel with sandpaper. And we will smoothen the rest as we did previously. We didn't record how we smoothen this with the Dremel because it's a lot of dust and we can do it in the workshop. But we just use the Dremel and obtain a smooth transition.
Removed everything was extra.
Yeah, my money. And now we will apply some glue. So this part has the glue and now we have to spread it on the lining part. And now we will wait. For this glue it's like 5 minutes wait time. The glue is dry enough and we can put them together. So do not press it, just place it as good as you can and use the eyes as guide. You just place it a little bit like this and see here. And we want to hide everything that doesn't look good. Like so. Like so. Okay, we don't press all the way now. We work on the other eye. This is, it got on it place. And when you're gluing, try to curve it a little, so they will
stay, laminate it.
They will stay on. They will be. It's better. I don't know. They stay like this now. You see.
It is a laminating process.
Go something like this. And don't hit eye. Should end up with something like this.
Well, I am the man with the knife. We will remove the excess of the lining. I cut almost everything with my alpha cutter, so this too. Take care of your fingers and take care at the googles.
You can always use sandpaper afterwards.
Yes, I like to cut it precise, so I don't sand very much. But it's better to use sandpaper than to make mistakes at this point. After all this work, these googles are the most complicated technology we know. It is about cutting precise, lining. Okay. We cut them. As you see, it is almost perfect. Now we will sand this and use some edge dye to cover. We have to let that primer dry as in instructions. This means more than a few minutes. You can spread the primer and the edge dyes with other tools, but on this process I prefer to use this brush.
We won't go too in depth with the edges because there is a lot else in this tutorial, and there are videos about how to make the perfect edges.
Okay, finish this part, let it dry, and then we will use
sandpaper.
We will use this edge dye and we will spread it exactly like the primer in the same way.
Okay, after you finish the edges, we will need to attach those rivets. This is a snap-on rivet. This is a normal attachment with the setter. But there's a little trick. This is a little different. You need to use two of those. And to get them together, we are using a
screw
with the Deci asta nu știu cum semnez.
Those two.
Basically, you get those sandwich the leather like this. Let's start. And you will understand better. First, we need to mark the holes. The holes are marked on the pattern. And one here. I will use a 3mm hollow round punch. The first upper snap-on rivets are normal. You just put them the classic way. Put it like this. Better to hammer it on a
heavy piece of metal.
Yeah, on a heavy piece of metal. For the fun part. First of all, I want to say I cut the screw part using a jeweler saw, like this one.
To have the proper length.
For the proper length. I'm not sure they are the proper length now. But we will see and cut it on shape if it's needed. So we start like this. We put one of those here. The best thing would be to use a little super glue. Now we need to attach two further parts of the fastener. We have a screw thread. I cut it on the perfect size, so it's good enough. And two nuts. All of those are for the 3mm size. So the inside is 3mm, the screw thread is 3mm. First, we put a little super glue on one end, like this. Just a little. Now, we put the nut, like this. Now, we get it through here. And through the leather. We attach the other part. And we will try to
screw it.
To screw it, yes. With whatever you have on hands. But
it's not easy, but eventually we will succeed.
It will take few minutes. No, it won't take. So now you can just do this. You can also add a little extra super glue here so it won't move. And I think it's tight enough. And this was it. stai așa, nu închide. I took the screw thread from a 3 millimeters screw. I use a jeweler saw like this one
to cut on the proper length.
And
vice.
I did something like this. Because you don't care about this end, you can
force it as you want.
Yes. And then arm the saw, tighten it, and you just cut like this. You can also use any other cutting method, and you end up with a screw thread. We finished with the goggles, and now we need to attach the snap-on rivets here to this part. And to this one. As always, we start with punching the holes. They are marked, they are on the pattern. If you already punch them, there's no issue. Try to be precise. This matters a lot.
The fasteners.
Because we have this part on the lower, we will put the mother. We take two of those and two mothers. We also take a piece of metal. And we go like this. Put it in. A little more. Same on the lower part here. Got a better hammer. And on the top, we have to put the fader parts on the helm. We take two faders, we take again two of those. Basically,
acoperi.
We are almost done. This looks pretty good.
Oh yes, indeed.
also need to attach the rivets here. And with the mother part, because on the we want to attach it here. So this is the trick that we did with the screws. Again, we need to test if it goes here properly, and it seems it does. Like this. We are almost done, but we forgot to attach those parts here, those two
buckles,
with the buckles. And we also need to put rivets for those small pieces, which will hold the respirator from falling. So if I leave it, it will open like this. Because we are at the river rivet part, we will attach the rivets first. So hold for the rivet. We need to stitch this part now. What you need to know is you don't start from the first, second, third, and fourth. You will leave four holes numbering like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we start stitching from this one. And we just make ribs on top of the already done stitching. This is also dependent on the thickness of the leather, so you might want to skip only 3, but this is really easy to restitch if it won't work perfectly. Because we forgot to do them, to stitch those parts from the start, those ones, we will stitch them now. And we are almost ready with this project. Again, this step, those holes, you will skip.
I need one more needle.
first two together like this, and now we go through the buckle part as well. Again, double the last step. Again, double the last step. Cut and burn and repeat for the other side. Now that we are done, we have to put the things together.